I'm with Nikhil Nambiar of Taurus Wealth Capital. This is a multi-family office. Hi, Nikhil.
Hi.
Lovely to have you.
Likewise, thank you.
You know, your company is based out of Dubai, and I'm told that you're also headquartered in Singapore, looking at investments in India. You're doing some things with family offices in India. Can you tell us more about that, about how exciting the space is and what sort of investments are flowing in the family office space?
That's right. Thanks, Aashika, once again. Like Aashika mentioned, I represent Taurus Wealth Advisors. We are a multi-family office headquartered in Singapore. We also have an office in Dubai for the last few years now. And we've seen a lot of activity picking up in the multi-family office space. We've seen a lot of business coming down our way. Dubai being Dubai is a launchpad for Africa, as well as in the Middle East itself. So we have a lot of interest. It is a fairly nascent market, so to say, but the space that we operate in is a very exciting space because we operate on a advisory fee only model.
Okay.
We don't charge commissions.
Okay.
We don't charge brokerages. Whatever comes to us as commissions or brokerages goes back into the client's account.
I see.
So we work on an absolutely unbiased, free from conflict of interest model.
Okay.
Where clients know that the advice they're getting is purely based on what they need and what they want,
okay,
not based on the commissions that we're making.
Okay. So you're managing family offices from India and otherwise also from which other countries?
We manage families and family wealth of families based in the Middle East, in Africa and in Europe. The Singapore office manages money for the families in Southeast Asia.
I see.
We currently have representations in our clients from over 24 countries.
What is it that you find most exciting about the Indian family office ecosystem? From what I know, everybody's very tight-lipped, and I can understand why you would be tight-lipped too. But what sort of scope do you see in the family wealth, peppering that we're going to now see?
Tight-lipped is a very interesting way to put it. It is indeed tight-lipped. At times, it's difficult even for us in the industry to get information out. But I think the key lies in the fact that it is a family office. It's not a publicly owned office, which is why people choose to keep it very, very closed and very personal and very private. There are no reports, figures, nothing which get published. We have no idea what goes on until you know who's doing what in which family office. Yeah. Very recently, we heard about a very large family office, Indian family office based in Dubai, losing a lot of money, losing about 300, 400 crores in the stock markets. But nobody would hear about it unless you're in the industry. We've seen over a dozen Indian families set up family offices in Dubai.
I see.
Over $400, $500 million of assets. It's significant wealth that we're talking about, but you wouldn't hear about it.
I see. That's interesting.
Yeah, and these families are very, very cutting-edge savvy, I would say, when it comes to investments. They know exactly what they're doing. They're hiring the right kind of people. They're seeking out experts like us, other people in the market, to help them manage and structure their investments. They're in real estate, they're in art, they're in equities, they're in private equity, they're in venture, they're in everything.
I see. This is an interesting thing to note. That
absolutely.
So Indian families are showing a lot of interest in Dubai, is what you're saying?
Very, a lot of interest.